Hello my dear students, welcome again for the online classes. Today we will continue with the same lesson of civics, that is lesson number 4, growing up as boys and girls. Now children, equality is an important principle of our constitution, but still being a male or a female should not become the reason for the discrimination. But still children, in our society we see the discrimination which is done on the gender discrimination, the distinction among the boys and the girls. Government has introduced the measures like Anganwadis, then child health care centers, etc. for the women to overcome this discrimination. We find the distinctions between boys and girls from the beginning itself in our society. That is, when a child is born, whether he has a identity as a girl or a boy. A girl, when she is growing up, always she is said that you should be soft and mild, your behavior should be like this, your behavior should be soft and mild, and always she is gifted with the toys like dolls, kitchen set, etc. Means she is meant only for the household activities, and she has to keep her behavior very soft and mild. Whereas the boys are gifted with the guns, cars, games, etc. Means they should be rough and tough. The behavior of the boys should be rough and tough. So this type of distinction we are seeing from the child is born. And so it should not be there. So this type of distinction which is done between a boy or a girl affects his role as a man and a woman in the future. So children, today we are going to study about the woman role, how her work is not valued. So first of all, we will study about the valuing housework. Many times you have heard that she is not a working woman. Means what? She is not a working woman means she is working as a housewife, and the role of the housewife is not an easy work, children. She is bearing the responsibilities of the whole household works and also the responsibilities of in-laws and children and her husband. Means the work which she is doing at the home, cleanliness, sweeping, cleaning, cooking, all these work also need a lot of energy, but her work is valued very less than the work which is done by a man. The women who are working outside, means the woman plays a double role. She is working in the home also and outside the home also. So children, the women who are working outside are playing the double role, means they have to take the responsibility of their home, in-laws, and all the activities which have to be done by a housewife also, and also she has to do the work outside which she is taking as a responsibility. So children, a woman, whatever her role may be, as a housewife or as a worker, as a working woman, but both the roles are very important. But these role of a woman is valued very less than the role played by the man and the work they do. The work which is done by a woman as a domestic workers, the ladies who are working as a maid servant, they are working at the different homes, they are doing all the work. So the energy, the effort which is needed is also more. They are also using their whole energy and efforts. Same way children, the man who is working outside, he earns money, but his role is given very importance, is very the role of a man, whether he is working in a big field or a small institution, but his role is valued very much than a woman. Why? So this type of distinction should not be there, but in reality we see such type of distinction in the society. So children, this is about valuing the housework. And the second point is women's work and equality. Our constitution has not mentioned anywhere that the role of the woman is less than the role of a man, but still in the society we see such type of distinction from the childhood itself. Now in our textbook, the example of the Samon Island and the Madhya Pradesh is given. In the Samon Island, they have to take care of their younger ones. So these type of responsibilities are given to the children, but instead of that, they are given these type of responsibilities. And in Madhya Pradesh, there are different schools for boys and girls. Why these type of distinctions are done in this? Why this type of distinction is done among the boy and a girl? The work which is done by a woman should be equal to the work which is done by a man. Actually, the woman is also using the same energy and she is also putting her same efforts as a woman. But still, why our society has given more value to the man's work, why not to the woman? So this type of distinction should not be there. Equality is an important principle of our constitution, and we have to maintain this principle in our constitution. There should not be any distinction between the man and a woman. So children, in this lesson, only the thing which is explained is growing up as a boys and girls. When a child is born with the identity of a boy and a girl from the childhood itself, he is given the treatment like a... Why he is given the different treatment, that a boy should be treated like this, a girl should be treated like this? Why? There should not be any distinction between a boy and a girl. A parent should grow both the boys and the girls equally. In some part of our country, still the distinction among the boy and the girl is done. So children, in this lesson, they have tried to explain the role of the woman, whether she is a housewife, whether she is a domestic worker, whether she is an officer, but whatever role she is playing, it should be valued equal to the role played by a man. So it is always said that the woman always plays the double role and she carries the double responsibilities. She has to take care of her children also, in-laws also, and she has the responsibility of all household works also. So children, the role of a woman should be valued more. So from this lesson, I want to tell you that the role which the woman is playing is very, very important and it should be valued. I am not saying that the role which the man plays is not important. No, it is important. The woman, role of the man is also important. Boys, the way in which they are grown up, it is also important that the boys should be strong and bold. Yes, but with that, the same treatment should be given to the girls. Because who says that girls should be soft and mild? Yes, it is true that the girls should be soft and mild, their behavior should be soft and mild. But still, with that, the girls should be strong also to face any difficulty. So children, it is very necessary, as a boy and a girl, both the gender should be treated equally. There should not be any gender discrimination in the society. So these two are the main points which is explained in the lesson. That's all. So read the lesson thoroughly and try to understand the concept. Thank you.